हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस वीणा सुनील पत्की, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. सो एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन, स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिराइव द ईएमएफ इक्वेशन ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर एंड कैन सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन इट. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर. When the source of alternating current is applied to the primary winding of the transformer, magnetizing current flows and it produces alternating flux in the core of transformer. The produced alternating flux gets linked with the secondary winding of the transformer by mutual induction, as it is alternating flux in nature. So according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, first law states that if any conductor or coil links with any changing flux, there must be an induced EMF in it. And second law states that the magnitude of induced EMF is directly proportional to rate of cutoff fluxes. So magnitude of mutually induced EMF in the transformer can be found by EMF equation of transformer. So if we consider the n number of turns in the winding, phi m is the maximum flux in the core in Weber. As per the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, E is given by minus n d phi by dt, where phi is the instantaneous alternating flux and represented as phi is equal to phi m sine 2 pi f t. As the alternating voltage is connected to the primary of the winding, so phi has the nature of AC. So we can write down the E equal to minus N d phi m sine 2 pi f t by dt. So after finding out the derivative of this equation, so we will get the equation E equal to minus N phi m cos 2 pi f t into 2 pi f. As the maximum value of cos 2 pi f t is 1, the maximum value of induced EMF E is given by EM equal to n phi m into 2 pi f. To obtain the RMS value of induced EMF, divide this maximum value by root 2. So E RMS is given by EM by root 2. So for this equation, E RMS equal to n phi m into 2 pi f divided by root 2. And after calculating 2 pi divided by root 2, we will get the value 4.44. So E RMS equal to 4.44 phi m f into n volts. So this is the EMF equation of transformer. Now we will consider this diagram, where the primary and secondary windings are connected on the core. So N1 and N2 are the primary and secondary turns. E1 and E2 are the primary and secondary EMFs. And V1 and V2 are the primary and secondary voltages. I1 and I2 are the primary and secondary currents. So we can write down the E1 equal to 4.44 phi m f N1 and E2 equal to 4.445 mF N2. So voltage ratio of transformer, it is expressed by the ratio of primary and secondary voltage. So voltage ratio is given by E1 by E2, and the turns ratio of transformer is given by N1 by N2. That is also equal to E1 by E2, because the induced EMF in the transformer is directly proportional to the number of turns of the primary and secondary. So we can write down the turns ratio and voltage ratio as E1 by E2 equal to N1 by N2. So if we consider the ideal transformer, losses in that transformer will be zero. So we can write down the input power equal to output power. That is V1 I1 equal to V2 I2. And from this equation, we can write down the V2 by V1 equal to I1 by I2. And if we equate all the ratio with one equation, then we can write down that ratio as a transformation ratio, K equal to V2 by V1 equal to V2 by N1, N2 by N1. So transformation ratio K equal to V2 by V1 equal to N2 by N1 equal to I1 by I2, where K is the constant and that is the transformation ratio of transformer. And if N2 is greater than N1, so K is greater than 1, then that transformer is called as the step-up transformer. If N2 is less than N1, then K is less than 1. So the transformer is called as step-down transformer. Now, pause the video and write the Faraday's second law of electromagnetic induction. So answer is, induced EMF in the coil is directly proportional to rate of cutoff fluxes. So E is equal to minus N d phi by dt. Now we will solve the numerical based on this. 80 kVA 3200/400 volt single phase 50 hertz transformer has 111 turns on the secondary winding. So calculate, one, number of turns of primary winding, then second, primary and secondary full load current, then third, cross-sectional area of the core if the maximum flux density is 1.2 tesla. So first you write down the given data, that is the kVA rating of transformer equal to 80. So V1 equal to 3200, V2 equal to 400 volt and the frequency F equal to 50 hertz and number of turns on the secondary N2 equal to 111, that is 111. Now we have to calculate the value of N1, number of turns of the primary, then I1, the current flowing through the primary winding, then I2, current flowing through the secondary winding, and A is the nothing but the cross-sectional area of the core. So we know the transformation ratio, that is K equal to V2 by V1 equal to N2 by N1 equal to I1 by I2. So put the values of V1 and V2 and N1. So we will get the equation as a 400 divided by 3200 equal to 111 by N1. So after calculation, we will get the value of N1 as 888. Now we can write down the equation, that is kVA, that is kilovolt ampere into 10 raised to 3 equal to V1 I1 equal to V2 I2. So 80 into 10 raised to 3 equal to V1 I1. If we put the value of V1 in this equation, so after calculation, you will get the value of I1, that is 25 ampere. And if we use the kVA into 10 raised to 3 equal to V2 I2, put the value of V2 in this equation. So 80 into 10 raised to 3 equal to 400 into I2. So after calculation, we will get the I2 equal to 200 ampere. Now, maximum flux density is given by Bm equal to phi m by A, where Bm is the maximum flux density, phi m is the maximum fluxes in the core, A is the cross-sectional area. So from this equation, we can write down phi m equal to Bm into A. So if we put this phi m equal to Bm into A in voltage equation of the transformer, we will get V1 equal to 4.44 Bm A F into N1. So put the values of E1, Bm, F, N1 in the above equation, where E1 is nothing but the V1, that is the primary voltage, Bm is the maximum flux density in the core, F is the supply frequency, and N1 is the number of turns for the primary winding. So we will get the equation A equal to V1 divided by 4.44 Bm F N1. So after putting the the values of Bm, F, N1 in this equation. So we will get the equation A equal to 3200 divided by 4.44 into 1 into 50 into 888. So after calculation, you will get the value of A equal to 1.35 into 10 raised to minus 2, that is in meter square. So cross sectional area is given by A equal to 1.35 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter square. So if we see this numerical, we can calculate the cross sectional area or the fluxes or the EMF induced in the primary or secondary, or we can calculate the number of turns by using these equations.